Hello, back again. We're doing a pastry, which is annatto, salt, 250 grams of Trex vegetable fat, which you can find in any supermarket, and about 100 grams, or 150 grams even, of margarine. It also has annatto in it, if I didn't explain this already. And that is to give it the wonderfully bright yellow colour that you get from patty pastry, normally. I don't like to use turmeric or curry powder, and I find the annatto gives the flour more flavour and more of a vibrant colour. So what I'm doing here is I'm crumbling the fat and the flour together. Crumble. Make it look a bit like a crumble that you would put on top of an apple mixture. Must be slightly grainy looking. And when you've done, put this down a minute. When you're done, you add cold water. Not warm water, this isn't bread. You add cold water here. And you add as you go along. So I'm going to stop here, and then I'm going to incorporate the water into this to make it into a dough. And it helps if you wear gloves when you're doing this. Because as you can see, it will really badly stick to your hands when you're first doing this. Now for the ingredients, the annatto I added was about a teaspoon and a half. You add salt to taste, and then you mix it into the flour, and you add your fat. And what you do now, when it starts to come together, you knead things together so it can come into a ball. I might need a bit more water. Just a drop. It's important to keep adding drop by drop, because you don't need this to be a batter, you need it to be a dough, paste dough. Trying to escape. Now it looks a bit orangey at the minute. When it bakes, it will bake into a lovely, brilliant yellow colour. Trust me. So you knead. I can see how I'm kneading it. Lift and press down. Lift and press down. And I'll show you again. Lift and press down. That is how you knead things. After kneading it, you're going to leave it to rest for about 10 minutes or until at least the mixture has cooled down so you can fill it. Roll it into a ball. When there is no more flour at any of the sides, then you know fully well that your dough has now been made. And also, there must be no lumps within this dough. It must be relatively smooth.
leave this to rest. I'll see you back in part 3.